Today, is Joe Biden a true friend to Britain? Will the government cut taxes before the next election? And do we need more workers from the EU? This is Politics Live. With me today, Conservative peer Ed Vasey, Labour peer Jenny Chapman, General Secretary of Unison Christina McEnee, and the editor of City AM Andy Sylvester. Today, all smiles as President Biden arrives in Britain for talks with the Prime Minister. It's the fifth time the men have met in 5 months, but with a growing list of policy disagreements, could it be an awkward get-together? Also today, are tax cuts before the next election now off the table?
As soon as we can, we will cut taxes, but we do have to be fiscally responsible about this.
This Brexiteer former cabinet minister says we need more EU workers to fill job vacancies here in Britain. Is he right? And no apparent end in sight to ongoing strikes, but are they working? Well, let's start with the story that the American president, Joe Biden, is in Britain. We can show you pictures of Downing Street. We're expecting him to arrive in number 10 very shortly. The world's press are all gathered, just out of shot for the moment, but you'll see all the cameras and all the journalists. And we're going to talk to one of the most prominent journalists, a member of the press, gathered there, the BBC's chief political correspondent, Nick Eardley. A significant moment, Nick.
Hi, Joe. Morning to you. It absolutely is. You know, when a president walks up this street and does the handshake, it's always a big moment. Interestingly, the photo of the day might not be here. It may well be the president when he meets the king later. But, you know, it's all about soft power. It's all about the US trying to show that that relationship with the UK still really matters. I think the big question today is whether there's much of substance that comes out of these talks, given that the president's here for about 40 minutes. I'm not sure they'll agree on all that much that they've not agreed on before.
Ah, well, you've mentioned agreements or perhaps disagreements, because actually they're not quite seeing eye to eye on some key policy areas.
Yeah, absolutely, particularly in the context of this week, Ukraine. So President Biden is stopping off in the UK en route to that NATO meeting. Of course, the US and the UK agree on the fundamental strategy of supporting President Zelensky and the Ukrainian government as much as possible. But there are two areas where I think that there are a couple of cracks when it comes to tactics. One is on those cluster bombs that President Biden signed off on going to Ukraine last week. President Biden says that was a difficult decision. It wasn't an easy one for him to make. But there is discomfort in number 10 about it. We know the Prime Minister doesn't agree. He said that he discourages the use of these munitions. It doesn't stop the red carpet being clean, no. Nevertheless. But the second thing that I think is really important here is what both sides are saying about Ukrainian membership of NATO. We all know that it's some way off. It's not going to happen imminently. But the UK has been talking over the weekend about Ukraine's rightful place being at the top table, being a full member of NATO. Well, President Biden, in an interview he did just before leaving for London, sort of said, well, let's not get ahead of ourselves yet. It'd be premature to talk about voting on Ukrainian membership in the future. There are still steps that they have to overcome, talking, for example, about democratic values. So in that sense, there's a bit of a difference as well. Does it change the fundamental strategy to the war in Ukraine? No, I don't think it does. But are there real differences when it comes to tactics? Yes, I think there are.
All right. Nick Eardley there at number 10 outside the big black door on Downing Street, waiting for President Biden to arrive. And we will certainly show you those pictures when the US president gets out of his vehicle and joins Rishi Sunak on the doorstep. And as we said, he's going off to see King Charles II. I suppose the question, Ed Vasey, is there are quite key disagreements over cluster bombs that the Americans are now saying are justified in the war on Ukraine. Yes, Ukraine's NATO membership, and there have already been ripples over Northern Ireland. Does it matter?
No, I mean, I think allies disagree, friends disagree. I think it's a very needy question that we always ask ourselves, you know, does America really like us? Does this president really like us?
Well, do they?
America really likes us. We have a fantastic security partnership with America, defence partnership, intelligence sharing partnership. Mm. We obviously have massive trade with America, many cultural connections with America. We go on holiday in America, they come on holiday here. America really likes us. So we don't need to worry about it. We'll disagree on things. On cluster munitions, you know, the UK government has been leading the drive to eradicate cluster bombs. So, of course, it's incredibly embarrassing. It is a useful reminder to all of us in Britain that America will do its own thing when push comes to shove. It will pursue its own interests. Well, it won't simply necessarily temper its policy to suit its British allies.
Do you agree? They really...